Today I'm going to talk to you about self-confidence and personal development. Who here would say they're a naturally confident person? Who's confident? By a show of hands, one person. One person, who's confident? Thinks they've got self-confidence. Two people out of the whole class, okay? Is it something that you think is common to most people? Self-confidence, is it common? It's not. But why do you think that I'm here teaching you about self-confidence? Why do you think I'm here teaching you about self-confidence? Why is it important?
Because we need to build that aspect of our lives.
Okay.
Confidence.
Why? Let me go to, I was going to say bright, but it's not bright.
It's important because as a student, you should be able to stand in front of a crowd or an audience to present what you want to say or what you want to teach.
Okay. Anything else? Any other reason? Exactly. It's really about having trust in your abilities, in your skills, even in your judgment. Yeah? That's what confidence is about. That's what self-confidence is about. And we'll look a little later, in about two slides, as to what the outcome of having self-confidence can be for people such as yourselves who are in university, and afterwards, what some of these effects can be. This journey is a very personal one. So when I was very, very, very young, growing up, I was a very confident child. So I used to dance then. I wanted to be a dancer, not a lecturer. I didn't ever want to be a lecturer. So I used to dance. My parents used to take me to dance school. So every time you see me, I'll be doing tap, I'll be doing ballet, and I loved it because I knew that, you know, I was actually good. I won medals and trophies and whatever. So that's when I was very, very young. And as usual, what happens is, even when children are quite young and they're confident, somehow, some way, as you're growing older, what happens? You may be confident when you're little, yeah, when everybody, when the world seems so great. But as you're growing up and you're a teenager, then the world comes in. And then you begin to doubt yourself. And I'm speaking from a woman's point of view, but I'm sure many can relate. You start wondering, am I good enough? Am I worthy enough? Can I actually do this? And when you add into the mix, it's not only intellectually, but even physically, your appearance. Do I look good enough? Am I a bit too big around here, a bit too, you know, other people's? Am I too tiny around there? And it ebbs away at your confidence. You don't really trust yourself. And I experienced this especially in my teenage years. In my teenage years, I remember that I felt like, you know, all parts of nothing was really good enough, yeah? So even to the point that I'm wearing black today, but when I was a teenager, I would always wear black. I would always wear bigger things to cover myself, even though, you know, it was because of, I didn't lack confidence. I lacked confidence in showing myself to people. I would cover my hair with caps and all because I didn't want people to see my hair. Even if I'm wearing, like, I wouldn't wear dresses. I would never, at that point, it was only trousers and dungarees. I didn't wear dresses because I didn't want people to see my body. So because of that, the way I presented myself was not very confident. Yeah? And the way in which you present yourself, if self-confidence comes out, it's seen to others, yeah? If you're exuding confidence, then people will respond to you that way. So that's what today's lecture really is going to look about. How do we, what, first of all, we'll look at why it's important. Then I'll give you tips on how you can do it. And I want this to be quite interactive and very practical, because it's inherently practical. It's not something that you only theorize over. At the end, I'll give you practical tips on what to do. But feel free to interject and ask questions. Okay. So I start off with this quote from Socrates: let him that would move the world first move himself. So if you want to make a change, and you are young undergraduates pursuing your degree, yeah? Many of you want to, you know, you've got high hopes, big dreams, great aspirations, which is great. But before we start all of those great and lofty things, what do we have to do? We have to put ourselves in check first. And that's what this quote is about. So, self-confidence, what's it do? Why is it good? It gives you inner strength to overcome difficult tasks. Throughout your journey here, even, and not even just in Gympa, yeah, in the real world, you're going to experience difficult tasks. In order to overcome these, what are you going to need? You're going to need confidence in yourself, confidence in your abilities, confidence in your judgment to do the right thing for that particular moment. One of the things is, as I've said, people tend to question you more when you lack self-confidence. If you come to me and I ask you a question and you're all hesitant and you're like, I'm not too sure, that will give me a leeway not to really trust your judgment or not really trust what you're saying, yeah? So, if we're going out, we're going to combat a lot of these difficult tasks, face life head on, we've got to do so with some kind of inner strength and self-confidence. Why is self-confidence good? Grace under pressure inspires others. We'll talk about that a little later. And I've given you some questions to ask yourself. You don't have to answer these now, yeah? But when you're reflecting, like Dr. Yowson said, you can look at these things. Do I show confidence in my actions? When I'm dealing with people, do I do that? Yeah. And I know in our cultural setting, people often equate confidence to arrogance. And it's different. Confidence is the trust in your own abilities. There's nothing wrong with that. Arrogance for me is where you have to put others down in order to gain that. That's not confidence. This is really focusing on yourself and your own abilities. Yeah? Even though I know that it can be misconstrued, but at the end of the day, yeah, if you're confident in your abilities, not in comparison to others, not in putting people down, yeah, in not thinking of yourself better than anyone comparatively, but you know your own abilities, that's fine. Okay, so here's something called the chain reaction, yeah? We talk about high self-esteem leading to self-confidence. So what's high self-esteem? High self-esteem is inner, yeah? So when we're looking at high self-esteem, we're talking about what are you telling yourself inside, internally, yeah? And self-confidence is almost like the outward showing of that inner esteem. I hope I'm making sense. So in and of yourself, what are you telling yourself? Even when you make a mistake, are you saying, oh, I'm so rubbish, I'm so dumb, I'm so stupid, I'm so thick? Are you saying to yourself, oh, okay, well, actually, maybe I made a mistake there, but I can learn from it. And I'll know not to do that again. And maybe I can do it another way, yeah? That you're telling yourself that. That's increasing your self-esteem. How you see yourself is an inward thing. And then your self-confidence is what we all see. It's something that is outer, yeah? So your high self-esteem, that's inward, which leads to your self-confidence, your personal effectiveness, yeah? Remember, you're trusting your own abilities. So that will make you more effective as an individual to do tasks, complete tasks. Yeah? And I've put the employability for you because, believe it or not, many employers look for these things. I've sat on many, many panels, many job panels. And there's a thing that the recruiters may not tell you. There's jobs, many of them, yeah, there's a technical component. But many people can do the technical component. Yeah? We have people with degrees, masters, PhDs, in all areas, yeah? Many. So what really distinguishes people? If I would argue, it's their character traits, especially their confidence. There's one awards panel, I won't mention the name, but I remember I was sitting on it. It's a scholarship program, and what we have to do, the CVs of individuals, like actually the level 100 people, and their CVs would come in, and then you would read their CVs, and then you would, you know, give a long list, and out of that long list of people that qualified, then you invite some over, and then the final list of the people that you will give the scholarship to come out. So the ones that on the CV, from the CV, I was really, you know, excited to meet them. And you think, wow, this person will be so great, so interesting, you've done so many things. And yet they sit before you, and then you want to fall asleep. Because they lack, yes, they lack. They've written some fantastic, maybe they've got, as Dr. Yao said, maybe they've got somebody to write it. It could very well be. But when you meet them, and there's some people who their CV wasn't fantastic, but when you meet the person and they speak to you and they've got so much confidence, you think, wow. And it makes all the difference. So yeah, that's what I wanted to show you, the reaction. That's why it's important. Yeah, and it's not only for employability in life. Yeah, it's not, I don't like saying these soft skills, it's not a soft skill, it's a critical life skill. I know in Ghana we talk a lot about, oh, you must be humble, humility is so important, and we talk about that, but we mistake humility for meekness. Yeah, there's a difference. You can be confident and still a humble person. Because humility is thinking of yourself less, not thinking less of yourself. So you can still be confident in your abilities and what you do, but not always have to center everything around you. You can be considerate and think about others. That's humility. But it doesn't mean that we have this sense of, oh, I have to put myself down and I have to, you know, say I'm not all that great so that people won't think I'm bragging or think I'm better than anybody else. No, that's not how it works. And that's why we need to take these things seriously. Okay, so when we're talking about self-esteem, that's the inner. Do you remember from the first box? Let me go back. So talking about self-esteem, which leads to self-confidence, personal effectiveness, and then employability. So, talk about self-love. I mean, some of these things can feel a bit touchy-feely, but when we're talking about self-love, yeah, it doesn't mean that, you know, you have to go around posing everywhere because I love myself. What it means, really, or taking selfies everywhere, just checking, I love myself. That's not what it is. What it is, be your own cheerleader. Be your own motivator. It's great when you have people that can go, yeah. I do it with my students. You're doing great. You're doing fine. You know, carry on. You know, when we're running, I mean, I hate athletics. Yeah? But you know, when you see people running and they're cheering on and, you know, it makes them run quicker. Yeah, but it's not all the time you're going to have people cheering you on. There's times when you have to make decisions that only you know that are right for you. So be your own cheerleader, yeah? Trust yourself. You are your leader in that sense. So you need to get that. And by doing that, by actually loving yourself enough to encourage yourself and motivate yourself, Yeah, you see how far that goes with your how you view yourself. Yeah, if we took a test now, you know, we don't have time, unfortunately. But if we took a test now, many of you would see, you know, you might not, how can I put it? You might not rate yourselves that highly. Some people don't even like themselves. It's true. Some people don't like themselves. You have to work on that. Get to like yourself. Fair enough, you might not have the same strengths as your friends or your colleagues, but understand that whatever you have was meant for you and you can use it to your advantage. So self-love, self-awareness, know what you're like, know what you're about. You need to understand it, yeah? Don't compromise on things that you know will just make you feel uncomfortable or you're not able to do. Know about yourself, yeah? There's certain things, me, I have a certain amount of self-awareness. I am terrible in the morning. If you get me in the morning, I'm so grumpy. I'm horrible. I know it. So I warn people, and my husband knows, before a certain time, don't ask me certain questions. But then I'm a late person. When I was studying, when I was doing my undergraduate, morning lectures, I hated like the plague. But if you ask me to do something at 8 p.m., 9 p.m., midnight, I'm fine. Yeah? Because I kind of know myself. Even now, I'm like that. So Gimpa suits me perfectly. Okay. So, clear goals. We all have to have goals. At the end, I'll show you a technique on how you set certain types of goals. But you need to have goals for your life. How many of you have goals for your life? Okay? And do you measure how far you're going to get to them? Do you actively work towards it? Are they realistic goals? Are they smart goals, actually? They are? You all have them? Okay. I'll just have to trust you on that. But you can do, I remember when, it's only 2019 is when, 2019 and 2020 are the ones where I used to have yearly goals, yeah? And I'll be like, oh, this year I'll do this. It's not only like to do with my career, it's, you know, to do with my life in its entirety. And I know life has a way of, you know, not always adhering to the plans that you've made for it, and you have to make allowances for that. But there's certain goals that you must strive to achieve. Like all of you, if you're in class now, yeah, you want to get a degree. That is something concrete, it's time-bound, it's achievable, it's realistic. You can do this, yes? I'm not saying getting a degree is easy. It is not. But that's a goal, yeah? And then you work towards it. Maybe you've got in your mind the class that you would like or the GPA you would like. It won't just fall from heaven, or you can't just say, oh, the lecturer should just give it to me. You have to work towards it. How are you going to work towards it? Of course, there'll be some subjects that you're better at than others. Yeah. The ones you're weaker, ask help. You can ask the people in the class, oh, you're really good with these calculations. Can you show me? Not can I copy so that I also pass, but can you show me so that I can understand? Because I find this a bit tricky. It's fine. Set those kind of goals. What I do is usually every year, I'll go on a course to learn. I still take courses, I still get certificates. For the past 3 years or 4 years, every year I've learned a new thing and got a certificate. My family laugh at me because they think after PhD, what more certificates do you need? But I still do it. I still apply for courses and I'll go and I'll learn different things. Because that's a goal. I want to be somebody who learns, is a lifelong learner. That's one of my goals. Okay, and finally, positive thinking. Yeah? when I was saying before, you know, when things go wrong, what do we say? Oh, I'm so dumb. Oh, it's my life. I've got bad luck. Bad luck follows me. Oh, it's my house witches. All of those kinds of things. Yeah. Reverse that negative thought. Sometimes positive thinking, you know, we think we can often base our thoughts, yeah, of ourselves on what other people say about us. But nobody knows you better than you know yourself. I found this quote: nobody can make you feel inferior without your consent. You allow people to make you see yourself as less than what you are. If you've got the confidence, whatever they say, they can't make you feel bad. Yeah, people say lots of things. Dr. Yalson was saying he's heard that people are saying he's wicked. Yes, did that bother him? No, because he knows he's not. Simple. Yeah, but nobody can make him feel inferior without his own consent, because he didn't allow it. I have taught some of you in this class, I'm sure some of you have thought I'm very wicked. However, I am not. You know, sometimes if you're confident, they'll be like, oh, this one is, she's too, no, she's this, I know my rights, woman, blah, blah, blah. Well, if you consent to those kinds of things putting you down and not allowing you to be you, then it's like you're in agreement. A consent is like an agreement. Don't be in agreement with that. Nobody can make you feel inferior. Okay, so we're looking at outer confidence again. How is this expressed, outer confidence? Oral communication, I know we teach that. Written communication, all of these reports, all of these assignments we ask you to hand in, it's to improve your written communication, which is sometimes is just as important as your oral. I've noticed as the years have gone by, our written communication is becoming poorer and poorer and poorer, but that's not good. You know, many of us with this text message, shorthand or WhatsApp language, let it spill into communication where it shouldn't. So if you're sending an inquiry, let's say about a job, it should be informal prose. Even if you know the person, do it so they know that you understand what's appropriate, you know boundaries, you understand about communication. I mean, I'm quite active on social media, and actually I should have put it on here. I gave some pointers for students looking for employment or even mentors, because I think we've lost our boundaries, yeah? You know Dr. Yalson, he's your lecturer. But even though he's your lecturer and he's very accessible and very nice, but even still, there's a way that when you're communicating to him, especially when if you're doing so written, there's a way, a manner which you do so, which shows that you're professional. And being professional isn't just about having a job. It's about how you conduct yourself. So that's very important. Also, assertiveness. What do I mean by assertiveness? I mean knowing what you want and going out to get it. It's not just about knowing. In Ghana, sometimes I'll ask people, I remember this one's a funny one. I those of you that are in my class know that I love doing my nails. I love doing my nails. So I had this particular nail technician, and I went to do my nails there, and then her brother came. And he was there, you know, yo-yo guy. And then he was telling me that, oh, he's going to drop a new sound of music, that when he drops it, you know, everybody's going to know in Ghana and the world about his music. So I was like, okay, yeah, let's see. This guy is a go-getter, yeah? So I engaged him. My nail technician was like, oh, don't mind him. But I said, oh, let me engage the person and let me see. And I said, okay, so this new sound, yeah, what's it called? He said, oh, jollof music. So I thought, okay, let me try and get the concept of this. I'm serious. It's jollof music, okay. So then I thought, so what does it, you know, maybe nice concept, jollof. Who doesn't like jollof? So, and because at first, when I heard that, oh, yeah, he's in entertainment and all, I thought, yeah, But then, after engaging him and his jollof music, and then realizing that our brother doesn't have a clue, yeah, he may have the idea, but the assertiveness to go out there and go and get it. He thinks that, you know, he should sing, and then we'll all love his jollof music and rush to him to buy it. The world doesn't work like that. If he'd have said, I've got this great concept of jollof music, and I'm going around, I'm playing this place, I'm going to this, I'm knocking on this door, I'm trying to get it on, and what's it called, Spotify or iTunes, or, you know, I'm actively doing it, or I'm going into Circle, and I'm selling my CDs and all of that, I would have thought, you know, great. And if he said, you know, he was looking up on YouTube how to improve this, how to do marketing, how to do that, I would have been so impressed. But I've noticed that many of us have, in Ghana, we have the great visions. You ask anybody, you can ask somebody, pick a random person on the street, and they'll be like, the amazing visions that they have for their life, where they want to go. But the assertiveness, the drive, the go get it, to go and go there and actually do it, yeah, that is what lacks. And that's what makes people stand out. And when being assertive comes at a price, we all have to pay it. Okay, positive self-presentation. That comes in many things. That comes in the way you conduct yourself. Yeah? It comes in the way, even your mannerisms, even the way you speak to people. Yeah? So it's not only, there's the physical, there's the appearance, yeah, which comes up a little later. That is important. But there's also the manner in which you conduct yourself and you talk to people. People that you might not necessarily know. So, you know, always put that in mind. And sound emotional control. We all, inherently, human beings, we are emotional beings. We shouldn't stamp that out, yeah? But sometimes emotions can cloud our judgment. So we have to know when and where to use emotion and when and where to put it in check, yeah? There's times where my students make me so angry. And I'm sure Dr. Yowson, you get the same thing. There's times where, you know, you drive us up the wall, sometimes. But, you know, I have to take my time. There's times where my students ask me to do things that could make me lose my job. And I think, wow, you know, you want me to throw all these years of my career, my training, education down the line because of your one request? When you think about it like that, it's really, 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 it can enrage you. But will I go and say it, the first thing that comes to my mind when my student is requesting this? No, I have to keep that under check. I may ask you a few questions. I may say that is really unreasonable and I can't believe you're asking me to do that. That's fair, but my initial response is not one that I would express to my students because I have emotional self-control.
So when I came to meet her, I see ladies moving around with nice shirts.
Oh, the figure eight and all. Gimpa figure eight.
Mm-hmm. And I'm like, look at me. And I told myself, you've got two kids. Two kids came out of this room. And so you have to love yourself.
Yes.
Present yourself the way you want people to look at you. And then people will respect you for what you do.
Very true. Yeah.
You have to first love yourself for somebody to love you. That is how it works. You don't look down on yourself and expect somebody to respect you.
Yeah.
Amazing you have them. Then talking about bad things can turn around to good things. That is in reversing negative thoughts. I only came to be that after the death of my family.
not something I thought would come to pass in my life. Because I have given up. Build up these dreams, what he wanted me to become. So I got up, 2018 was a very bad year for me. I lost two brothers and my mom. Then in 2019, I heard there was a February intake in Denver. And I told myself, I'm not going to sit in the house. I need to get something to do with my life.
Yes.
I came to Denver, I started the entrance exams, I blew it. And here I am today.
Yay.
So,
that's excellent. I mean, on the both of the points, I really relate because, you know, life happens. Life, it does, it happens. And I remember, you know, with the confidence thing, when our physical appearance goes through changes, I used to have a lovely figure. I used to. And same thing, say yay. But the same thing that happened, you know, after giving birth, then your body doesn't do what it's supposed to do and all. And mine was a little bit different because unfortunately, and this is not something that I, you know, I don't have a pity party over it, what I'm about to share. But unfortunately, my daughter died, you know. So you're there, you're thinking, ah, got all this fat, and the little one's not running around to even go for the fat. But then you think, you know what, yeah? I am growing to love you, yeah? In all my facets. Okay, but I have to buy the good ones. It's not going to work. Sometimes, like, yeah, the cabin split has to be left out a bit more. It's fine. You know, it's not the end of the day. And as much as physical appearance is important, yeah, the way, you know, you dress and you're going to, especially if you're going to formal events and things like that, but it's not the only part of you. I mean, recently I've been thinking about that a lot because I've been thinking more about my health, yeah? So me, that I hate exercise, I hate it. I've had to engage a personal instructor, not necessarily because I want my old body back. It's just that I don't want to die young. There's a difference between it. So, you know, and I don't have any of the lifestyle diseases. I don't have pressure, I don't have cholesterol, I don't have diabetes, but I don't want to wait until I get them, yeah? But, you know, life and the way it is, you're not going to be the same. Even if you've, you know, maintained your figure, and, you know, God bless you for that. Even if you've done that, you as a person change. Life experiences change you. Yeah, but they don't necessarily have to make you negative. I know this lady, she's been through a lot, yeah? And she's one of my biggest role models. I mean, she's been through hell. She had to start her life like over again. You know, she got married and then, you know, unfortunately it collapsed. Then she had to move to a different country, start off from nothing, start over again, met somebody else, thought everything was okay. Then that went pear-shaped. And then the person took loads of money, like half or over half of what they earned, refused to look after their responsibility. It was a nightmare. So you would think this person would be, you know, the person is fantastic and, you know, so positive. So when you see the person, you're like, oh, isn't this a lovely woman? I can learn a lot from her. But when you hear her story, because she's turned those negatives into positives, you will just want to listen to her and listen to her and listen to her. Okay? So that's what we can do. Our negatives, yeah, as much as they hurt and they can, you know, they can... you know, crush you temporarily, yeah? But there's a process, and in that process, you learn. You came to Gimpa out of a very tragic situation, which is now turning good. There's other people, their own is different, yeah? And another thing I've not put on here, but you need to be willing to share these things, yeah? I'm not saying expose your whole life history. I'm saying that somebody needs encouragement from that. There's people who, you know, maybe are wondering, can I actually do GIMPA? Can I come? People ask me that. I want to enroll in GIMPA, but I'm not sure. I'm like, well, you'll never be sure unless you try. So try. Do it. Get on there. It can be tough, especially if you're working and then you're coming to GIMPA. We know, but we are trained to be able to teach non-traditional students. Yeah? That's why you've got extra special lecturers at GIMPA, and you need to just appreciate us. But no, seriously, in GIMPA we understand non-traditional students, and even when we are doing our courses, we keep that in mind. That's why we're trying to be more engaging and more interactive. Yeah? It's just better to be an optimist than a pessimist. Yeah? Even though we know negative things happen, you know what? We hope for the good, and it's fine, yeah? Maintain composure and self-control even under difficult circumstances. Some people say, you know, sometimes when things happen and it really, really, you really want to shout, they say, breathe, count to 10. Yeah, I've not tried that, but apparently it works. It works. I know with the kids, you're supposed to give them a timeout. So the kind of breathing, when I'm angry like that, I just won't respond. It's better because once the words come out, you cannot take them back. So you just say, okay, can we talk about this later? And then that's the, because in that heat of the moment, yeah, you might legitimately say certain things, and then afterwards you think, oh, I wish I hadn't. And remember we said about this whole thing of being confident is about having sound emotional control. I mean, nobody has mastered it perfectly yet. And there'll be days where, you know, you might be a little more on edge than others, but it's something that you must practice. Okay. Be proactive in taking the lead, even when this might be risky. Yeah. There are plenty of opportunities, whether in this GIMPA context, whether in the outside world, to take the lead and be proactive. So I'll just read them and not go on too much. Obtain and attend to feedback from others without defensiveness. There's people who are there, they're your cheerleaders, but they're also there to help you when you go wrong, yeah? And you need to be open to criticism or people telling you maybe where you're going wrong. Doesn't mean it has to diminish your confidence. You can even be more confident in that. So if somebody genuinely says, oh, I'm sorry, but I think you have been a bit abrupt. When you talk, you're abrupt. You don't have to say, no, I'm not like that. Just, okay, thank you for that. I'll work on it. And do work on it, yeah? Okay. Be reliable to do things on time and up to standard, yeah? Self-explanatory. Demonstrate a set of values that colleagues respect and buy into. Okay, you stand for integrity. Consider new ideas with an open mind. Don't be closed. Oh, this is the way we've done things all the time. We don't need to do it like that. Why are you changing it? No. Consider it. Consider new ideas on their merit. Some of them, they might not be good, and you can place an argument as to why. You don't have to accept everything, but just be open a little. Generously share your time, knowledge, and skills with others. I think I've talked about that. Sharing your experiences. If you know how to do something, somebody asks you, if you're able to show them. Know when to say no to less important tasks at work in favor of more important priorities. Or I should have put in life. Learning to say no, yeah, is an important life skill. Especially in an environment where you know, saying no equates to evil, yeah? But there are times where you have to draw clear boundaries on what you can and cannot do. Be consistent in what you say and do in all situations. Okay, so this really, I won't go into it, but we're talking about how our gifts differ. So if you know that our gifts differ, you can be confident in that, okay, this is what I have, yeah? And this is what I'm going to work with. And this is what is going to take me to where I need to go, okay? So about changing, yeah? Because maybe we're still on this journey where we're not, you know, when I asked the initial question, there's only a few of you that said you do have that self-confidence. So for the rest of you, and even for the ones that do have it, you can get more. It's still a journey, yeah? And can we change? So what I've written is that we have to accept and appreciate our own gifts and contributions and the different gifts and contributions of others in our team or in our workplaces or even in our environments, while always seeing the possibilities for change and improvement. Change and improvement. You don't have to change and go worse in ourselves and in others. And just about how we can cultivate to be much better. Okay. So here are the practical tips that I was talking about, yeah? Give up toxic worrying. Yeah? I am a natural born worrier. Yeah? I am somebody that, you know, if one thing happens before, I could make it spiral so that like the whole world is coming to an end. Yeah. And I will chew on it and then toss the thing round. You know, like you know when cows are eating, apparently they chew, that's what I used to do with the problem. And it doesn't do anything. You don't find solutions that way. It's just pointless energy. It's energy wasted, spent uselessly. So don't give up that toxic. Try to find solutions. Seek what the real issue is, yeah? And then tackle it like that. Yeah? Now what I do, something serious, I just try and then take a step back from it. Just for that point, a few points in time. Then when I cut back, maybe I'm refreshed and I'm not so bogged down by the way the situation may seem to overwhelm me. Okay, let guilt go. Yeah, and don't dwell on regrets. Yeah, learn from them. If you make a mistake, it's fine. Learn from, we all make mistakes. I've made mistakes, I'm making mistakes, I will make mistakes. But I will learn from them, that's the most important thing. Okay, ask for help. I've said that if you know you're deficient in a key area, ask for help, approach somebody and ask if they can help you. Find a mentor. Yeah, I know there's a lot of talk in these, especially in Ghana, oh, get a mentor. And we usually want the same kinds of mentor, yeah? But I've not got one composite mentor. I've got people who I go to for different things. There's certain people that I can go to with regards to career. My gran, who unfortunately is ill, when I'm talking about my career, then I'll call, I'll be like, oh, grandma, you know, do you think this will be good? There's other people that I can talk to if I am dealing with other kinds of things, yeah? Maybe you might not get one composite mentor that is great at everything, but you can get advice or people you can go to for certain elements. Okay. Challenge yourself, yeah? Push yourself, you know? Try, go that extra mile. As I said, this year, me that I hate exercise, I have a regular trainer. Not because I love to. I hate waking up at 4:30 in the morning. But because I want to stretch myself. I've got a goal. I want to challenge myself that I will be fit. Okay? And you can do that. Said mistakes. Okay, responsibility. So I do this with all my class. I tell my classes that, you know, you take responsibility for your own marks. So if you get an A in my class, you've got an A, you deserve it, you got on merit. If you get an F, you equally deserve it, and you got that on merit. So for your successes and your failures, you take responsibility, okay? Be self-reflective, look over, okay, maybe what could I have done, you know? We don't spend enough time reflecting. I used to do that. I mean, I do it now. I'm trying to do it in the morning. Sometimes I do it at night. But you need to take time out and think, okay, what has gone on today or what has gone on this week? How can I improve? What things can change? How can I move forward? How far am I in achieving what I want to? Take that time. It doesn't have to be long, but really, I call it like a self-audit. I set personal goals, I've said that. Okay, so this is kind of the last bit. So one practical way of achieving your goals, especially with your learning, because of the kind of environment we're in, is to set personal targets and achievement. It helps keep you on track towards goals you aim to achieve, and creating a plan can help develop more confidence in your ability to tackle new things, yeah? Because you're recording these, and you're recording how well you're doing, and you're achieving them. Okay, so this can be like your learning, part of your learning plan, yeah? And you put what you want to achieve, the objective. I will be capable of doing something, yeah? Let's say you want to be capable of, what are some of the things you want to be able to do? Doing things, anybody?
Improving on your education, like maybe...
That's quite broad.
Last year, this year, like I'm targeting in.
It has to be more kind of specific than that. Somebody here said communication skills. I want to be capable of doing a 20-minute presentation. Yeah? Let's say. Because now a lot of the interviews you'll go for jobs, they'll ask you to give a presentation. Some of the ones, the one that I was talking to you about where the guy did brilliantly, there was actually a formal exam before the written communication. For the oral communication, that was hard. Okay, so this will require a change in the following skills, knowledge, and or attitude, yeah? So you want to improve your communication skills, yeah? So what skills you have to improve? Maybe the way you even present yourself, maybe the way you talk, maybe the way you project your voice, even your posture. Certain things, maybe you'll have to read on presentation skills, some of the best tips. They might involve reading certain books and understanding certain things about language, the kind of language you use, yeah, or interacting with your audience and how to do that. So you would write that down, and then you write somebody, it can be a friend, because we talk about accountability partners, will something almost measure your target behavior. So let's say it's presentation skills, and you want to be able to do a 20-minute presentation because you're not good at that, yeah? And then you will get maybe an accountability partner and say, look, yeah, over the next 3 months, give yourself time, yeah? I want to have at least, you know, read a book on presentation or watch three YouTube videos. And then also I want to have done a mock run of a presentation. There's so many practical ways, yeah? And count them, say, you know, I'll watch 3 YouTube videos, read 1 book, I'll do this for that. Anything you can measure, yeah? The target behavior, which is presentation skills, to a certain standard, which is 20 minutes, yeah? So you document this, and you're specific, so you know whether or not you've reached your target, yeah? Things that are so broad and flowery and not really that easily measured, yeah? You lose track of them easily. So back to my exercising example, which I hate exercising. Before I started exercising, all my stats were taken. Yeah, I'm not just talking about weight. I'm talking about the speed of my metabolism, my hydration levels, my muscle content, my fat content. Everything was taken. Why? Because I want to measure my progress. Yeah, it's not just that. Last month, we found out I'd lost a little, well, quite a considerable amount of weight. Yeah, so I should have been happy. Yes. Of course, when you're exercising and you lose weight, I should be happy. Can anybody guess why I wasn't happy? No, but can anyone guess why I was not happy? Pardon?
Losing weight wasn't the reason.
Yes, exactly. So I was losing weight where I shouldn't have lost weight. Because I thoroughly measured all my statistics, yeah? I wasn't actually losing fat. I was losing muscle. And muscle weighs more than fat. So my fat is still there. It's my muscle that's going, the muscle that I need to build up. So I was really disappointed. And my trainer was like, never mind. Yeah, it doesn't matter. We can still hear. But that's when you set specific targets. That's when you know. So everybody's like, oh, do you mind me? You've lost a bit of weight. And I'm like, oh, please. It's only muscle. It's not fat. So, you know, and I genuinely was not happy, you know. So when you set specific targets and you know what you want to achieve, yeah, even to the outside world, it might be that, oh, you're on track and you can get caught away. Yeah, I'm losing weight. Let me buy new dresses so that, you know, I feel good. But it's not really about that. It's about you being specific, knowing what you want to achieve and working towards achieving it. Okay, final one. Accountability partners. These help, yeah? In my quest to get fitter, I have two accountability partners that happen to be sisters, and we're all on the same WhatsApp platform. One lives in the UK, one lives in France, and I live in Ghana. Yeah? But we track each other's progress because we're all trying to get fit. We're all around the same age. So it's the same with you. If you've got certain goals that you want to achieve, yeah, you can take one or maximum two. That'll ask you, they'll ask me also, Jemima, how's it going? Yeah? Is your body still aching? Are you still trying to eat healthy? And all of these kinds of things. So it helps. We said initially be your own cheerleader, but it helps when you also have somebody that you're accountable to. Even when you make mistakes. Over one weekend, I ate so much cake and all, but I was accountable, yes? I'll probably find out this month if it's taken its toll. But still, even if you're not fully on track, you know, when we think of accountability, people, we say, oh, we'll tell them when we're doing well, yeah? And when we're not doing well, we'll hide it. No. They're to help you get on track. Okay, so that's my presentation. Thank you very much. Any questions?